My name is Bayo Ware. I am a senior project manager in the renewables department of Energy Trust of Oregon. Energy Trust decided to work with community organizations on low-income solar because really that is in accordance with our mission. We receive funds from all customers of private utilities of Oregon and Southwest Washington. So it is our goal to return those funds to those same communities. And we noticed that over the course of our history, we haven't done that equitably. So that led to a lack of skill set that our organization had in meeting those customer needs. And we knew that we could reach those needs by partnering with those who had those areas of expertise. Energy Trust has worked with community organizations in multiple different ways. The first of which is through the LMI Solar Work Group. That just entailed us finding organizations in the Portland metro area and just telling them about what we do as an organization and how solar works, what solar is, how to obtain solar, and learning from them in what their organizations do, what their priorities are, what their programs are, and how they work. Another way that Energy Trust worked in low-income solar is through the Solar Ambassadors pilot program, where we worked with some of those same organizations previously and new organizations to build a curriculum around solar access and awareness. We use that curriculum to train members of Black, Indigenous, and people of color communities to share that information with their friends, family, people who they talk to on a daily, weekly basis. Another way that Energy Trust works with CBOs is through the Working Together grants. That is an up to $10,000 grant for CBOs to share information on clean energy resources, mostly that Energy Trust has to offer. And in addition to that, it provides an opportunity for organizations that we don't really have a relationship with yet to learn about what we do and so that they might develop and build, so that we might work together to further enhance and nurture that relationship to do more engaged and complex work in the future. Another way that Energy Trust works with CBOs is through the development and implementation of the Diversity Advisory Council. We knew that we had some areas in which we needed to grow to serve not only communities that experience low incomes, but also communities of color and rural communities. So we reached out to organizations that serve those different demographics to develop a council that can advise us on our program development, as well as our organizational strategy. And some of those same organizations and new organizations in turn became a part of the Diversity Advisory Council and continue to provide us with feedback. Working with CBOs has greatly enhanced Energy Trust's ability to fulfill our mission. Specifically, they have also helped us to grow in our understanding of what those community needs are. And in addition, they work to help us meet those needs through a partnership with them. State organizations and organizations like Energy Trust have a lot of expertise that they have gained and honed over decades. However, CBOs and other organizations in the community also have areas of expertise that they have honed in the same amount of time. And so really it's about leveraging the resources and the expertise and the knowledge and the relationships that those CBOs have and that we have so that we can work together to achieve our shared goals. We use that curriculum to train members of
Black, Indigenous, and people of color communities to share that information with their friends, family, people who they talk to on a daily, weekly basis.